Today we'll be talking about important questions or commonly asked questions, frequently asked questions for the Bachelor of Physiotherapy from thorax section and also from embryology, general anatomy. So let's start with thorax. 5 markers which are short essays. External angle. The sternal angle is the joint that is between manubrium and the body of the sternum. So there are some important changes that happens in this area. So that is one question. Then characteristic of typical ribs. So you have to number what are the typical ribs and explain features. Features of first rib. First rib is an atypical rib, so you need to mention how to identify the side of the rib, attachments and so on. Briefly describe the intervertebral disc. You need to mention about the parts of intervertebral disc. Curvatures of vertebral foramen. There are primary and secondary curvatures. You need to explain on this. So these all are from introduction to thorax. That's subsection. Now, wall of thorax, in this long essay can be name the muscles of respiration, describe the diaphragm in detail. So there are muscles which causes respiration. So they are like intercostal muscles. So you need to explain about intercostal muscles, diaphragm. So diaphragm anyway, you are going to explain in detail. You'll be explaining about the origin insertion of diaphragm, different openings and so on. 5 markers, intercostal muscles. Need to explain different intercostal muscles, origin, insertion. 2 markers are draw and label a typical spinal nerve. So typical spinal nerve diagram, this you can get from Cunningham's, the first volume. Structures in intercostal groove. So the structures in the intercostal groove, the intercostal nerve, vein, artery. So there is an order for it, so just mention about that. Next subsection is thoracic cavity and pleura. The 5 markers are pleura. So you need to explain the pleura, the different layers of the pleura, and the costodiaphragmatic spaces also can be explained in this area since it is for 5 marks. The 2 markers, parts of parietal pleura, just mention the parts of parietal pleura, the costal pleura, cervical pleura, diaphragmatic pleura, mediastinal pleura. Pleural effusion, it's a clinical question, so just mention what does it, it's a collection of fluid in the pleura. Innervation of pleura, so just mention about the innervation, the parietal pleura and the visceral pleura, how it is differing and which are pain sensitive. All those things. Name the pleural recesses, costodiaphragmatic and costomediastinal recess. So we have to just name it. Clinical importance of pleura. Again, just mention something related to the pleura, like the pleural effusion and so on. The next topic is lung. Here the 5 markers are bronchopulmonary segments of the lung. Here they asked left lung, so you can get a question from the right lung also. So please practice the diagrams. Hilum of the lung, you need to mention the hilum of right and left lung and differences between those. Mediastinal surface of right lung. So here again the question can come from mediastinal surface of left lung, where you need to mention about the different structures that is seen on the right lung. Structures at hilum of right lung. Again, this question can be structures at hilum of left lung. You need to mention about the different arteries, veins in that area in order, anterior to posterior, superior to inferior in that order. The bronchopulmonary segments of right lung, as we already described here in this. So you need to mention what is a bronchopulmonary segment is, how it is clinically important. Now define bronchopulmonary segments, give its diagrammatical representation and clinical significance. Here question is very specific. You need to mention about the clinical significance and the diagrammatic representation of right and left lung. So this is going to be lengthier. Arrangement of structures in the hilum of right and left lungs. Again, you need to know the order in which it is arranged, right and left lung. Two markers are structures passing through hilum of lung. Again, it's repetition. Define bronchopulmonary segments, where you need to just mention, just define it. No need to explain much in two markers. Next topic is mediastinum, where five markers are trachea. Yeah, trachea can be asked. Yeah, it's an important thing here, trachea, which we usually miss. Two markers, formation and termination of thoracic duct. Another thing, thoracic duct formation, it begins in the abdominal region from cisterna chyli. So that you need to mention. It's two marker. Arch of aorta, the branches of arch of aorta can be mentioned in this, the beginning and the end of arch of aorta. The next topic is heart, where the 10 marker discuss in detail external anatomy, that is external features of heart, internal structures, we need to mention the different chambers, blood supply, we'll be talking about coronary arteries and the coronary sinus of the heart. So we need to explain few things in this. Enumerate the chambers of the heart or write in detail about right atrium. Here give more importance to the each chamber, the features of each chamber, the parts of each chamber. So here you need to mention about external and internal features of each chamber, but give more concentration towards right atrium. Now describe the blood supply of heart in detail. So here you need to mention about the arteries and the veins of the heart and clinical importance of it. Now other this is regarding 10 marker, right? Yeah. And the 5 markers are here, pericardium. You need to mention about the layers of pericardium, sinuses of pericardium, arterial supply of heart specifically asked. So you need to mention about right and left coronary artery, cardiac dominance. Discuss the right ventricle. Here only explain the right ventricle, external features, internal features. External features, how, which surfaces which it is forming, which border it is forming. Explain the blood vessel that is supplying this area. Conducting system of heart with a not on applied anatomy. Here we'll be mentioning about all the conducting system, SI node, AV node, Purkinje fibers and so on, with applied aspect. Arrhythmia is an applied aspect of it, so you can just mention. Venous drainage of the heart, specific questions. Question, here coronary sinus, the branches of, I'm sorry, the tributaries of coronary sinuses, the venous drainage in detail, coronary sinus, exact location of coronary sinus, which are the veins draining into it. Describe the right atrium of the heart, is again a 5 marker question. Right atrium in detail, external and internal features, the parts of right atrium internally, anterior part rough, posterior part smooth. Two markers are coronary arteries, mention about the coronary arteries origin of it, from where it is originating. Blood supply of heart, write in short, very short. Okay, don't explain here because it's two markers, so write in very short. Let's see the next topic, that is general anatomy. Here in this you can get a question, the 10 markers can be classify joints with example, describe the synovial joint in detail. So here the joint classification has to be mentioned in brief, but the synovial joint should be explained in detail with different types of synovial joint. Next question is classify bones with examples. So here you will be mentioning about again the classification of the bone, on which basis it is classified. There are three bases on which it is classified, and draw and label microscopic structure of TS of compact bone. Here you need to draw about the histological appearance of transverse section of compact bone. Here the diagram carries marks. Classify joints with examples, again the same thing. Describe the ligaments, movements and muscles responsible for movement of hip joint. Here it is specific, so this you can get a question of this in the lower limb, because hip joint is seen in the lower limb. So in general anatomy you won't get this question as such, hip joint, but you can get questions related to joints classification. And this question is specific to lower limb, where you can get a question like asking ligaments, movements, and muscles responsible of hip joint. Anyway, this we can discuss in the lower limb. But remember, joints classification can be asked in general anatomy. So in the first sessional, you may get questions from this. Five markers are ossification. Again, you need to mention what is ossification, what are the rule of ossification. Epiphysis. Explain what is epiphysis. It is the end of a bone. So the blood supply of epiphysis. Saddle joint. Explain about saddle joint, how the articular surface looks. Examples of it. Blood supply of long bone. You need to detail about the different blood supply, nutrient artery, epiphyseal artery, metaphyseal artery. You have to explain everything with a diagram. In anatomy, please try to draw the diagrams. Classify muscles with examples. Here you need to mention about the classification of muscles, especially you can mention about the different muscles, skeletal, smooth, and cardiac muscle. So in fact, you can more detail about skeletal muscle classification according to different criteria, according to the fibers. Skeletal muscles are classified in detail into different subsections. So you might have heard about it. So that you have to read and draw some diagrams. So this is five marker. You have to, for this answer is lengthy. You have to make it short. Two markers are sesamoid bone. So these bones are formed in the tendon. I need to mention about the examples of it. Dermatome. Explain what is a dermatome. So it is related to the spinal nerve. So you can get better explanation in the Cunningham's. Types of epithelia. This is a histological question, in fact. Different types of epithelia. It's a histology topic, so please read that. In that way, give some diagrammatic representation of it. But if it is two marker, just mention, that's better. No need to draw the diagrams in two markers. But five markers, you have to draw at least one diagram. Now here the question is very specific. Draw and label a neuron. So until unless the question is specific, you don't have to draw diagrams in two markers. But here it is specific. Draw and label a neuron. So it's very simple. Draw a neuron. Function of bursa. So bursa is related to the synovial joint. So you can just mention about that. Some of the examples also can be mentioned. Classification of bones. Again, just mention in short, very short. It is two marker. It's very lengthier answer. Function of bursa, just mention about the function, like it is main function is lubrication, right? Yeah. Coming to histology part, 10 marker can be define and classify connective tissue, giving suitable examples. So here the classification of connective tissue, which is very broad, you need to explain in detail. And specifically the question is microscopic structure of compact bone. So here mention about the compact bone, TS and LS. Both the sections has to be mentioned in this, because they have not asked anything specific. So please remember that. Here you can get a question like the same question which was asked, that is epithelium. Classify different types of epithelium, that also can be asked. A five marker here, microscopic structure, histology of long bone. So you need to just mention about the histology of long bone in detail. Microscopic structure, very superficially you have to mention. Skin, you need to mention about different types of skin, the thick and thin skin, how it is different, so that you have to mention. You have to draw the diagram as well. Histology of skeletal muscle, again drawing the diagram, TS and LS. Histology of elastic cartilage, here the diagram is also important. The elastic cartilage, how it is different. The elastic cartilages have the cells which are the largest cells among the three cartilages. So you need to mention, you need to picturize it. Elastic fibers has to be seen, perichondrium, etc. Histology of hyaline cartilage, where it is very peculiar, the glassy appearance of the hyaline cartilage with the smallest cartilage cells can be mentioned in this. Histology of lymph node, where you need to detail about the afferent and different fibers, the cortex, medulla, the lymphatic nodule in the cortex, medullary cords, medullary sinus in the medulla. You need to explain in the diagram. Okay, when they ask histology specifically, you have to draw the diagram. Otherwise, skin, when it is asked, you can just mention about some features, gross features, but again, concentration should be towards towards a diagram, because they don't ask like the skin, they ask histology of the skin. So if they ask specifically histology of the skin, you need to draw the diagrams clearly, so that these marks are for the diagram, not for the explanation as such. Now describe the structure of hyaline cartilage. Again, it's a repetition question, so repeated question, so we can read on that. Hyaline cartilage, they have the cell nest, so mention about all those things. You have to draw it with hematoxylin and eosin pencils. Microscopic structure of compact bone, again they have asked microscopic structure, so the TS and LS has to be mentioned because nothing is specifically asked here, but usually they ask transverse section or longitudinal section, so that would be more easy. Two markers are name the cells of the bone, so different types of cells in the bone: osteocyte, osteoclast, osteoblast, osteocytes, right? These are the different types of bone cells, and osteoprogenitor cells also, which are the mother cells. So just name the cells. Histological diagram of large sized artery, so it is specifically asked. So usually they don't ask like this in the two marker, but if it is asked, you have to draw the diagram, large sized artery, where you need to mention about the different layers of the artery, tunica, intima, media, and adventitia from inner to outer. Histology of transverse section of compact bone, again this question is very specific, so draw only the compact bone, TS, transverse section, where you will mention about the osteon, different osteocytes, how it is arranged, all those things. Histology of hyaline cartilage, again it is specifically asked, histology diagram, so please draw the diagram of it. So draw the perichondrium, draw the different type of cells, draw the different layers of the perichondrium, different cells within the cartilage, the cell nest, again the shape of the cell, size of the cell, you know, different type of staining, all those things has to be mentioned very clearly in the histological diagrams. Please manage the time as well. Now embryology topics, five markers can be fertilization. You need to explain detail about the process of fertilization. There are different changes that happens at the time of fertilization. You need to mention about that, the determination of the sex, the maturation of the ovum, all those things happens at that time. Blastocyst, what is blastocyst, how can you define the blastocyst, what are the developmental stages it arrives in the blastocyst stage, what are the steps for the formation of blastocyst, what can happen after that, just make a note of it because it's five marker, explain little detail. Derivatives of ectoderm, there are different derivatives from the ectoderm like skin, epidermis of the skin, the nervous system, there are a lot of things, so mention all the things because it is five marker. You can also explain how the ectoderm is formed, just give a note on that. Two markers are structure of spermatozoa, you need to mention about the different parts of it, the head, the neck, the tail of the sperm, what the head contains and so on. You don't have to draw the diagram, but just mention in two markers until unless it is asked. Mention any four derivatives of ectoderm. Again, it's very simple question. Just mention about the four derivatives. Just mention about that. You can get a question from endoderm also. Mention, they can ask you, mention any derivatives of endoderm, mention any derivatives of mesoderm. Chances are there. Ovum, explain different stages of ovum, formation of ovum, mature form of ovum, the different follicles, how it undergoes primary, how it becomes primary follicle, secondary follicle, graphene follicle, what happens, what are the changes inside the follicle, what happens to the oocyte, just mention, okay, not much detail. Name any four derivatives of mesoderm, yeah, it's asked mesoderm derivatives. Like this you can get a question like name any four derivatives of endoderm, spermatozoa, repeated question, so please note that also. You can just mention about the capacitation of the spermatozoa. Oh yeah, here it is asked structure of spermatozoa, yeah, correct. So you need to mention about that. Don't draw the diagram here if it is not asked, and don't waste the time also in two marker. Just write the points, don't detail, don't write in pages, just mention the points. Okay, thank you.